Each day, Catholic Charities provides help, but the way we do help is to create hope in people's lives, because it's the hope that treats them with respect as made in the image and likeness of God that they can move forward on their own to live their lives in even greater dignity.
New York's always been a city where people come to get a better life. Catholic Charities is there to provide hope to those people so that they can build a future for themselves, be successful, and live a good life.
In Harlem, our Lieutenant Joseph P. Kennedy Center responds to diverse needs. The hungry are fed through year-round food programs and our annual Thanksgiving meal distribution. Foster families are nurtured and supported. The elderly are cared for and welcomed into a vibrant community. Through the Transition to Adulthood program, youth develop valuable skills to help them succeed in college and life.
Skills that I picked up were mostly language and literature skills because I kind of have dyslexia, so it's kind of hard for me.
It's a cool program. It helps you actually think about going to college.
They always told me not to give up. It's like having a second home.
I think this organization is unique in terms of it not only addresses their economic need, but it tries to address the person. And I think we do it genuinely from a place of caring.
What we really want to do is encourage people and create hope, have them feel that they can lift themselves out of the situation and become empowered to actually better their lives.
Leslie Lopez had to give up her job and lost her home to care for her two sons, who would have died without heart transplants. Catholic Charities supported them throughout their ordeal.
It wasn't just my son's health that they were concerned about. They were concerned about us as a whole, as a family. Catholic Charities made sure that I got the opportunity to see my boys alive and well.
When you're in a crisis, all you can see is that moment. And the needs that you have at that moment have to be met. They just have to be met. And Catholic Charities spends a lot of its time, effort, and energy ensuring those needs are met.
In the past 2 years, I've attended college and completed some training so that I was able to actually register my own daycare business. And with the help of Catholic Charities, they're actually helping me to continue that dream. I'm able to work and support our family. And I think there's no greater gift than being able to help myself.
Isabella Rivera was dealt a triple dose of tragedy. She was stabbed by an intruder. She lost a second son to illness. And she was forced out of her home because of a fire.
A referral caught my eye when I read that the building was in a fire and this client was left homeless.
Catholic Charities provided help by paying for Isabella's temporary housing and holding her apartment during renovations. We are creating hope for her future and the opportunity for her to go home again.
I am working for my place, but I promise to go home. Try to be positive. To the person I'm positive. Positive.
And now you know what I see when I have the luxury of leaving the office and going out to see Catholic Charities in action. There I see a person's dignity enhanced when everybody is called by name, when they're treated with love and respect and welcome. This is a vibrant family. It's a family of close to 100 agencies serving all New Yorkers, regardless of religions. But we can't rest on our laurels. We got a glorious past, but we're looking to the future. And we got to continue to strive to find even better ways of providing help that creates hope in human lives. Our faith and our mission require no less.
Thank you, Catholic Charities.